It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangilawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.
Yeah, what's that?
Seven.
John G.
If I lose, you got four.
Yeah, John G.
Okay.
We good?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Ryan.
I got something. Come here. Come. Hard to hear.
Mr. Patrick.
Hello.
I'll be calling you. I'll stay in touch with you.
What are you gonna call me?
Got some military stuff.
Okay.
Got you covered.
Great.
All right.
Take care.
All right. He's 27 years old.
Huh?
Yeah. 27 years old. Oh.
But was that long? 27 weeks.
He's there for us, buddy. He's there for
us.
I'd like to call the Rural Power Protection District number 3 to order. Regular meeting July 26th. Roll call, please.
Mr. Flores. Mr. Ingrapia.
Here.
Mr. Joseph.
Present.
Mr. Bruno.
Here.
Mr. Richtel.
Yeah.
Mr. Mayhew.
Here.
Mr. Wells. Mr. B.L. Ms. Hobb. Ms. Coates.
Here.
We got David. 11?
He had to leave.
Okay, do we have a quorum?
6. We got 5.
Okay.
We got about 5.
You got a quorum.
Mm-hmm.
6. Yeah, we're good.
You're good.
Okay, anyone wishing to address any agenda items? Okay, the chair will entertain a motion to adopt the minutes dated 28 June 2021.
So moved.
Motion by Mr. Bruno, second by Mr. Mayhew. Roll call.
Mr. Ingrapia?
Yeah.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yep.
Mr. Richtel?
Yep.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells? Mr. B.L.? Ms. Hodd? Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Motion passes and so ordered. LaRonda Primatis, we'll take these one at a time. Replicates of approval of full-time position. That should be in your packet.
He's got 3 of them, right?
Two.
One.
Three.
One full-time, 2 part-time.
One full-time.
Oh, I missed the third one.
Three.
Y'all want to take them all at once?
Yep.
I so moved. Okay. Motion by Mr. Bruno.
Second.
Second by Mr. Mayhew for approval. Roll call, please.
Mr. Joseph.
Yes.
Mr. Bruno.
Yes.
Mr. Richtel.
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew.
Yes.
Mr. Wells. Mr. B.L. Ms. Hodd. Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest? Mr. Ingrapia?
Yes.
All the paperwork's with Dennis on the 3 LaRonda. Dennis has all the paperwork.
Yes.
Did you tell everybody what's the matter with Dennis?
Yeah, we sent an email out to him. As a matter of fact, Dennis sent an email out to all of you all.
Is he sick too, or he just...
No, he's not sick. He's quarantining, but his wife is the one with COVID. So let's pray that she has a speedy recovery. Monthly reports and registers. We're going to skip that one. Administrative report, as you know, Dennis is not here, but Laura is here. We take item 3, audit presentation from FY12-3120. Laura Green.
Yes, sir.
She has 3 minutes.
So, all of y'all have this bound report, but on top of it is a letter it's from Laura Gray. It's on top. It's the very thing.
Mm-hmm.
This letter is dated June 25th, 2021. So this is called the governance letter. It's addressed to you. You are the ones that govern the district. So this is kind of called the exit letter. Would like everybody to know that I met with Mr. Vial. I met with Mr. Joseph, Dennis Crocker. We had consulted with Dennis James, your accountant, and asked him, did he want to come to the exit conference on June 25th? He had opted out. He was meeting with y'all at the same time. Like, he was doing the exit conference for TPG. But he and I worked very well hands-on, so he didn't feel the need to have to be there. He already knew everything. So this is the letter that it basically kind of wraps up the audit process really quickly for you guys. It talks about what were the significant audit areas. It tells you that I did not encounter any lack of authoritative guidance or consensus, like weird transactions should not be in there, something that looked funny. Y'all do use estimates in this audit, which means it's not a hard number. Depreciation is an estimate, and allowance for doubtful account, that's people who aren't paying their property taxes, we have to set up an allowance. Those are the two large estimates used in this audit. Y'all have two notes that I'm going to bring to your attention. They're in your audit report. If you have time, you should read them. They're significant because of dollar size. Note 7 is your long-term debt note, and then note 11 is about tax abatement for your information about the taxes that, because of the program through the economic development, and we forwent some income. Were there any difficulties? That's the bottom part of this letter that I encountered during the audit. No. Were there any conflicts? There were none. The client was cooperative. There were no disagreements. We did have the management representation from what we call management. Dennis Crocker and Dennis James is referred to management. Y'all are governance. They answered all the questions. They provided me all the information and any audit adjustments they've posted. Fire number 2 has a finding this year. It's a budget finding. And y'all will all know that budgeting is a process. It's kind of a really good guess. Because y'all are adopting the budget in October. Things can happen towards the end and year-end adjustments. And I will just tell you, it has to do with the radio lease. The $521,000 radio lease, it's a paper journal entry that had to be made at the end of the year. That's all it is. Dennis James knew about it. He brought it to my attention right off the bat on the first day of the audit. These things happen. It didn't blow you up. It's not going to affect y'all getting any funding with the state. It's just y'all went over the 5% budget. You know, there's that rule. You can't go over more than 5%. If you do, it's a finding. And you did. And it was this one journal entry for the radio lease. So that's for you. This kind of sums up the whole audit for you. Like, it went good. Now, I'm not going to go over the bound report. That is your copy. I was talking to Ms. Coates. I think Kristen also gave y'all another copy, and then you have one on your iPad. Y'all have lots of paper. We can say we support the timber industry very well. And but I'm not even going to cover all the slides. We'll go through these really fast. This is the highlight of your audit report. Let's flip over, because I think now I only have like 2 minutes. Remember, I don't cover all the volunteers, okay? These are the 8 that got the audit. And I'm just going to kind of talk fast. We do not audit Kentwood or Natal Benny. Kentwood is included in the town of Kentwood's audit. Natal Benny gets their own audit. They have their own auditor, and they submit their audit report to Ms. Pecorera. Fire District number 2 and the 8 volunteers received a clean opinion, an A-plus opinion. Financial records are materially correct, and there's also another opinion about internal control. The internal controls over financial and compliance are also clean. Even though you do have the little budget finding, it does not affect your internal controls. There's a thing called the MD&A on pages 5-9 of your report. It's supposed to be plain language, but it is not. But it's a standard that says you gotta have it, and that's in there. And we only reported on public funds. There's no volunteer money in this audit report. It's only public dollars. Overall, the district had an increase in its net position of $582,464. The volunteers as a whole had a decrease in net position of $260. Flip over. Here's some highlights. You can just see, I'm not even going to read it. You can see the departments that had positive change. You can see the departments that had the negative. A negative, in your term, would mean a loss. And then LaRonger has had a negative net position. That's a deficit. But this year, they chipped away at it. They actually ended up with a positive change, a profit, per se. So they are working down their deficit, which is they're moving in a correct position. That means they're not spending every single dime. You know, they're saving some. They're bringing some more to cover that, which they should. They're doing a good job. All right. So the next page, this information comes from page 11 of your audit report. and it's the statement of net position. I've give you a four-year graph there just for you to look at. You can kind of see everything, kind of some of it just stays flat. The receivables, there's a pop-up in it, but that has to do with the levy of the property taxes and the first payment. In the prior year, we got a payment in December, and this year, we did not get a payment till January. So there was more property tax to accrue.
Can we utilize some of this in our committee to help us with anything, or are we pretty much set on what direction? Any information in here? That this is more past four than the next, you're more concerned about the next four than the past four.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Because this is going to, as you know, we got all of that information coming for the next meeting on all of the breakdowns. But this is, we're going to get a copy of that, but that's a good idea. We'll get Kristen to make some copies, and we can show some of the departments those graphs, because that's a lot better than just seeing numbers, you know. Good idea.
So just remember my graphs, like here, and it, you can use them whenever you want. These are fire number two. This does not include the eight volunteers, this data that I'm talking to you on this page, okay? So, but you can kind of see, so the total assets for fire district number two is $17,223,058. There is a big jump in the capital assets also, but we had some big purchases this year. The next page is fire number two's liabilities and net position. This is also on page 11 in the big bound report. Total liabilities as of December 31st, 2020, $2,537,213, and total net position, $14,685,845. You can look, accounts payable is always kind of level. There's no big, the due to volunteers, it kind of stays level. It has to do with, this is the money that we give them at the end of the year. It all just depends on property tax money when it's collected. So that's why the due to volunteers is a little higher. You have the next little section is long-term debt. And then you can see the other there. Flip over to the next page. Fire number two, revenues. This is on page 15 of the big report. $7,532,714. Really would like to point out to you, and I think y'all should just be kind of excited, but everybody else is going to get excited because they're going to want all the money. If you notice, property taxes increased $342,044. That's during COVID. There was a lot of worry that how was COVID going to affect property values. This is not a sales tax. This is a property VAT. But, you know, we had a lot of businesses that, you know, might have shut down or left the area. But this is good news. Are I don't get that information. When I test the roll, I test the roll for all of fire number two. You would need to contact the assessor's office if you wanted to. But what I'm saying is, y'all didn't see a dip. So that means, look, we're in 21, which, I mean, we know we have a spike, but the economy is recovering. We're trying to get open back up, which means property values in the parish are holding. So this is a good thing. And then you can see the other revenues kind of hold. State revenue sharing, which is basically the homestead exemption that's given back. 2% fire, state supplemental pay, that's for Dennis. A little interest income. And then the money that we get from Independence and some of the other little fires that pay y'all to provide fire protection district. There's a FEMA grant that was for Kentwood, but it got run through fire number two. The grant was in the name of fire two, but it's strictly for Kentwood. So that's the revenues. Next page. Now we're going to talk about expenditures. And so we spent more than we got. So we had to dip down in our reserves. Total expenditures, $7,645,284. And you can kind of see everything kind of stays level. We don't really fluctuate very much, but that's because, y'all, we have a contract. It controls the term. The only big jump we have is in other administrative expenses. If you looked at 19 to 20, there's this huge jump, $230,000. Well, $216,640 of that is Kentwood. So we had to record the money in, but we had to send the money out. So that's that FEMA grant. And then just wanted to explain capital outlay. Prior year was $102,517,000. This year is radios. Most of that's radios. All right. Next for y'all. So you have this nice graph, and it has all eight volunteers. This is what we'll call the balance sheet. This shows their assets, liabilities, and net position and by each fire department. But as a whole, this is in the total column, total assets of the eight volunteers, $7,211,282. Total liability, $610,656. We have a positive net position of $6,606,26. The only fire department that has a deficit is LaRonger, but this has to go back to a couple of years when they had to borrow some money to buy a fire truck.
Yeah.
So, but they are, like I said, they're slowly cutting that deficit, you know, making it smaller. And well, it's evident on the next page.
Every year. But really, mm-hmm. I guess it, I don't know how to explain it. They borrowed money from Ponchatoula to buy mm-hmm. the truck. And then they make payments to Ponchatoula mm-hmm. for the money. So what do we have to do? Because I hate to keep seeing this reoccur every year. We know it's a note. We know we borrowed the money. We have the paperwork mm-hmm. to do it. What would we have to do to clear that up? Is there any way to clear it up?
Ponchatoula is not going to tell you, sorry, we forgive it. You don't have to pay us back. I don't ever see that happening.
Oh, no. I mean, we don't intend to do that.
So.
But can we set it up as a note?
It is a note. That's why you have this deficit. Like, it's no different had you gone to a traditional bank and borrowed the money. Because you still have to show the purchase as an expense. But when you got the loan proceeds, it's a loan. It's not a revenue. So we had this expense, but we had no revenue to offset it because a loan for nonprofits, see, their accounting is different than Fire 2. That's why they have that.
Should we have done that differently?
No. No, because it was a good business decision.
I don't want them to get a bad rap that
paying
their debt.
They are paying their debt, and they actually had an excess that they're now reducing their deficit. So the thing for LaRonger is they have to be mindful of their spending and their budget, which they are. They're not just going hog wild, spending, and they're trying to cut into it. Because had they gone to the bank, they still would have to pay it. So Ponchatoula had that extra money. Ponchatoula makes interest off of it, but at a cheaper rate. I mean, they're helping everybody out, but unfortunately, because of accounting rules, it can't go away. Oh, it's back here. It's in the. But one, I mean, Manshack's not here, so they can't like throw darts at me. Another thing would possibly be is another fund would just give money to LaRonger. Just give it to them, you know, and we would have this coming in as a transfer. But I don't know if they'd do that.
Yeah,
I mean, they have $1 million. Oh, their money. Man Shack has $1 million in the bank, I think. Y'all are building a building. Mm-hmm. So all I'm just saying, I mean, I just. Yeah, but they're working on it. But you know, I didn't know what the plan was for Man Shack. I mean, they have this, but nobody really is manning it. Didn't know if another fire department was going to think about absorbing it. So that's that. Let's move on. I don't want to be controversial. But I do want to present to you on that page right across here. This is the one that says expenses, program revenues. There were three departments. Hammond had a negative net change. Manshack had a negative, and Wilmer had a negative. Now, Hammond, they had huge equipment. So did Wilmer. And this is Manshack, and I've talked to Dennis James about it, and I talked to Crocker. They're just spending too much money.
Who is that?
Manshack. They did not buy any equipment of substantial thing for them to have $27,000 negative. They spend money they don't have. They spent more money than they took in. But yeah, they had a surplus, but they've always had this big surplus. But their regular operations, like for example, Hammond had an X, they spent too much, but it was for a fire pumper truck. They knew that their reserves was going to buy this new fire truck. Man Shack is just, it's every year. It's not just one time. I mean, and I'm not being disrespectful, for the last 15 years, Man Shack overspends. Uh-huh. Like, they just spend it. And I'm trying to figure out, and I asked, it's almost a defunct department. You got one person, and I don't understand why it's overspending.
They're spending their surplus. They're not necessarily.
Well, I get that, but what? But my thing is as long as y'all are saying you can, in the normal operations of a year, you can always overspend, and it's going to come out of your surplus. If you want to build a new fire station down there, you also need to be aware they're overspending in regular operations, so they're chipping away at the surplus to build the new fire department.
Well, they buy the necessary stuff.
So,
they can use and apply.
Well, I think he wanted to buy another truck tonight, a pickup, and he just bought a one-ton dually.
So what I'm saying is, as the Fireboard, y'all have to approve all capital expenditures over $1,000 anyway. So if it's your plan to build a fire station down there, y'all control the reserve. So then it's your place to tell the chief, you can't just keep overspending every year and take away from your reserve. If he wants to do that and y'all want to do that, that's fine. You're just not going to build the nice fire department that you want. Well, I don't have that information here. It's a one-person place.
Yeah.
It's one person on the payroll down there.
I understand what you're saying.
So.
That makes sense. All right, go ahead.
Okay, keep going. Next page. This is, it's called the Schedule of Long-Term Debt, fire number 2 only. You can see we started the year with $139,177. We added $512,814, which is the Motorola radios that y'all got. It's primarily Kentwood and, I don't know, is it Natal Benny? There's a whole bunch of them. There's 50-something radios. The reduction is what y'all paid on the leases for the trucks. So the balance at the end of the year was $615,761. The principal that's going to be paid in the year 2021 is $143,514 for budgeting purposes. The other notable items is if you wanted to see the debt that the component units own, this is the debt outside of Fire 2, page 34. On page 36, note 11 is the tax abatements. And just so you know, it was $32,218 is the amount of ad valorem tax that was abated to businesses that had signed the agreement with the Industrial Development Board. You know, this is to bring business to the parish, and for a certain amount of time, their taxes, their property taxes, are abated. But then after that period of time expires and that agreement, then it'll kick in and they'll start paying. So. We have a budget compare schedule on page 39, and the overage on the budget has to do with the radios, and that's the only finding that y'all had this year. Y'all haven't had a finding in a really long time, and it's just one of those accounting things that snuck up. It came in after the budget was presented and adopted. And that's it. Y'all all have my number. Y'all can call me anytime. You can email me if you have any more questions. If you need more details, I can get those for you. I would like to just tell you again, thank you for continuing to use me to do the audit for fire number 2. I'm always available for any questions, any concerns, or even if you want to report something and you don't want to go to the legislative auditor, you can come to me, and it is confidential. So.
I wonder, with the changes that Metallica has made in the last few months, if they would be considered joining.
It would save them money.
Yeah, I was wondering. I mean, I'm okay with doing it the way they want to do it, but that's my kind of mind here.
But Dennis and I have visited the fire departments, and we haven't gotten there yet. That's one thing we're going to talk about. That's what we're going to talk about.
Yeah, they may be willing to do it now. Because I think they're paying about $8,000 a year to do that audit.
There's no reason not to do it along with the rest of
it. Be the same.
So I don't disagree with you on that, but the audit fee would change. You know, it wouldn't be what we've got. And then No, they may. We would have to look. I would have to look at their audit reports to see what their auditor's been finding on them and issues. Because when they used to be part, remember?
I'm not aware of that. I know we get a copy of it all the time. I'm not aware that they've...
They're having... Yeah, well, I haven't looked at it, so it would just be looking at it and just that, and then just giving y'all a new...
I mean, $200 added to your contract.
$200?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You can do that in cash.
Woo, yeah. So. Oh, and just so you know, your report was submitted to the legislative auditor on June 26th. It was due June 30th. So Fire District Number 2 is in compliance with the state for reporting.
Let me ask a follow-up question. Do you recall that auditor coming and talking to the...
There's our Kenwood. There's never... Now, they do send us a copy every year.
Yeah. They just required, in the past, it's just required to send to the secretary of the Fire Board. Okay. They don't normally come.
All right, Laura. Thank you, Laura. Do you need a motion to accept? I make a motion to accept.
That's for y'all. That's all yours.
Stand by the same rapidly.
Can burn on them, step on them, run over them.
To approve the audit report, roll call.
Mr. Mitchell?
Yep.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yep.
Mr. Wells? Mr. Leah? Ms. Hodd? Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest? Mr. Ingrathia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes. All right. Good job. Thank you, Laura. Okay, next item. Approval of renewal of agreement between the Parish Rural Fire Protection District number two, Wilmer Fire Department, LaRange Fire Department, and Tangi Fire Department District number one. I talked to Dennis, and he said this is a routine, something we do every year. You all looked at it? You have any questions about it?
Yeah, that's those separate contracts.
Contracts, yeah.
That we have with Tansh Baho.
Oh, okay, yeah. Uh-huh.
But the one at Tansh Baho is due to be renewed. And I think that's what that is.
Tick
files
included in here?
Huh?
Is tick files included?
Yeah. Tick file, Tansh Baho. Hammond has one.
Roseland, I think.
Yeah. So I'll make a motion to exercise those those.
Nothing's changed, though. Nothing's changed.
What it was, Kim, years ago, Tansh Baho, Tickfall, Roseland, they didn't pay the millage to the parish for fire protection. They went back and passed a 10 mil tax inside. And they give that money to the fire district to give to that fire department in that area. Now, in the case of Hammond, we give money to Hammond to help with the fire, and we give to Ponchatoula to help with the fire. But in the case of Tansh Baho, Roseland, and Tickfall, they pay the millage to us, so the contract never changes. It's based on the 10 mil. So I'll make a motion.
Well, let's include the village of Tansh Baho as well.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
Any motions?
Yes, sir.
All right. Motion by Mr. Bruno. Second by Ms. Singer to approve items 4 and 5. Roll call, please.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richler?
Yes.
The motion passes and is so ordered. Are there any other prime matters?
I would like to thank our spill-in secretary tonight.
You did a good job. Didn't ask me the first question.
Yeah, we did a good job.
She did a tremendous job being put into a hard situation like she was tonight, but she came out just like a champ.
I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help. Don't be intimidated by large insurance companies who just want to make your problem go away. We are here to represent your rights and interests. Contact me today at tangilawteam.com and let's get to work.